me now because you don't want to miss any of this. And we are about to holidazzle you. Enjoy.
Lola, Lola, you're on stage in 10 seconds.
Thank you. commission. Well, you better have a good explanation for this. So take a side street. This is not what I agreed to. All you said was that this would be a great photo op. That's all. You never said anything about me having to stay here and serve. There you go, honey. God bless you, too. I know they're homeless, Bernie. Yes, I could think of it as a good deed or something. But good deeds are so much easier by checkbook, don't you think? Oh, here, I hope you like beef. Or is that chicken? Well, whatever it is, I hope you like it. Oh, rats! Oh, it's not rats. Just chicken or beef, that's all we serve. Bernie, one of my acrylics broke off. Oh, this is unbelievable. It must have fallen off in that last scoop. I told you I'm not cut out for this kind of work. It's too hands-on. Now, Bernie, how you ever let me talk me into this is beyond me. Now get down here before that lady who's chewing on her fingernails figures out they're not her own. Get over myself? Get over myself? Have you been talking and listening to that Don Hamilton over at Capital Area Christian Church again? Well, what could he ever do for me and my career? Nothing. Absolutely nothing. You're just unbelievable, Bernie.
Oh, how's it going, Lola?
Oh, fine, Reverend, fine.
Well, we really appreciate you giving your time to the mission like this.
Oh, Reverend, I couldn't dream of eating my own Christmas dinner, knowing that there were those among us going to bed hungry.
Yeah, well, we're grateful. Check some things here.
Did you hear that, Bernie? That was my best yet. Now, where are you with the video camera? I could never fake that kind of sincerity again. Oh, that's true. I'm an actress. I can fake anything.
Oh, what's that?
Oh, I said if there was anything that I could do, please don't hesitate to ask.
You know, we really couldn't ask you to do any more. You've done so much for us. We're very, very grateful, though, for all that you've done.
Oh, Reverend, I just... these people are giving me so much more than I'm giving them.
I'm going to go check some things, okay?
Okay, thanks so much. Bernie, we are talking germs. I'm telling you, if I come down with some kind of fatal disease and die, you're fired. Yeah? And you're off my Christmas list, too. What's that? You're pulling into the driveway now? Well, it is about time. Enjoy. There's plenty more where that came from, unfortunately.
Lola, sweetheart!
Finally, take your picture and let's get out of here.
It's gotta look real, Lola. It can't look staged.
But it is staged, Bernie.
I know it's staged, but it can't look it. You gotta be serving them or something.
Just snap it.
Oh, that's good. That's perfect, Lola. One, let me get one more. One.
Are you getting
magnificent.
My best side?
Oh, I always get your best side.
Wonderful.
Okay,
soup.
That's great.
That
let's go.
Super.
Let's get out of here.
Let's go.
Yeah.
You're forgetting something.
What?
I signed you up for 2 hours.
Well, it's been 2 hours. It has to be.
Just 18 minutes.
I have 18 minutes left?
You've only been here 18 minutes.
Just let them take it out of my paycheck. That's fine. We'll just get going.
Okay. We're out of here.
Oh, you guys leaving so soon?
Oh, I'm so sorry, Reverend, but I completely forgot about another engagement that I have.
Oh, man, that's a shame, because we're really shorthanded. We were counting on you.
Oh, if there was anything I could do to rearrange my schedule.
Well, maybe there is.
Absolutely not at this late date. No.
I suppose you're right. You are helping at...
The Helping Hands Mission.
Yes.
Wonderful people. Marvelous people.
You're going over there this afternoon?
Oh, yes.
Oh, that Helping Hands mission, that's on
Bradley Avenue.
Actually, I think it's on, 3rd and Main.
3rd and Main, of course.
Yes, yes, we always get lost going over there.
Oh, well, you know, you don't have to worry about that, because I'm going over there myself this afternoon. You can just follow me.
Follow?
You?
Well, sure.
You want us to follow you?
Sure, well, I mean, this is so great. 2 missions in one day. I can't believe this. Man, we need more people in the world like Lola. You know, somebody that's so warm and so real.
Oh, she's something, all right.
Oh, I'm just doing what I can to make this world a better place. You better have film in that camera, Bernie!
I think she's okay. 280 AD, a small baby boy was born to two loving Christian people, And they were very much convicted about the importance of demonstrating God's grace and mercy to the people they came in contact with. And they raised their son to have those same values. This boy's parents died when he was a teenager, and he decided to get involved in the ministry, and he eventually became a minister in a small coastal community. And the lessons that his parents taught him, and his love for God and his corresponding need to show God's grace to other people, well, that continued to characterize his ministry. And he was always giving of himself to other people and seeing to it that year-round, people that had need saw to it that those needs were met as much as were within his ability to do so. Now, the interesting thing about this individual is word of his generosity and his demonstration of God's grace to other people really began to grow. And St. Nicholas became known just about every place. You know, if you think about the name St. Nicholas, if you kind of give it, you know, a pronunciation from the area where this guy grew up, kind of comes out like St. Nicholas, you know, where you place the emphasis on the second syllable or the other syllable there of Nicholas. So even having Santa Claus as a part of our celebration experience is also very much remembering what it is that God did for us through the giving of his son at this special time of the year.
I have a question out here. What would you like for Christmas, sir?
Thank you. Give us
It'll cost what?
It's a bad season. If you would have asked me in March, no problem. But in December, what do you want me to say? Look, I can give you a great deal on a plucked chicken and a pine tree. Wouldn't that be just as good?
No, it's gotta be a partridge and a pear tree. I explained it to you already, just like the song. I gotta get all the things. I want it to be perfect. It's gotta be perfect.
Okay, but it'll cost you. The price for the bird and the tree is a perfect $350. Will you be using your American Express card or another form of plastic?
Turtle doves are not pigeons. Jeez, where do they find these brainless salespeople?
Gold is so popular during recessionary times. I'm afraid I can't quote you anything less than $500.
That one's pretty tough. We don't get many milkers looking for jobs. I got cleaners. My dad can clean your house for a mere $100 and a tub of buttered popcorn. Of course, he doesn't do windows or milk.
With union wage, transportation, room, board, and taxes, that'll be about $5,000.
Leave and Lords? How about wrestling tickets?
Wrestling tickets? No, I need Lords a leaping.
Haven't you ever been to a WWF match? They think they're Lords and there's a lot of leaping going on. Hey, work with me here, okay?
Well, it cost me all my savings and my college fund, but it was worth it. Merry Christmas, Julie.
Worth it? I've got people running all over my house with drums, enough animals for a barnyard. I can't sleep with the noise. My neighbors have signed petitions and are trying to have me evicted. And to top it off, I'm allergic to birds. Merry Christmas.
Next year, I'll get her gift certificate.
Didn't know you'd come to save us, Lord, today. 'Cause we didn't know who you were. Sweet little Jesus boy, a long time ago. Didn't know who you were.
Christy.
What are you doing?
I'm shopping for you, girl.
What'd you get me?
Like I'm gonna tell you. Hang on. Christy's on the phone. Let me do a three-way call. Hey, Christy.
Hey, girl. Like, what's up?
What are you doing?
I'm at the mall, and guess what? I'm shopping for you.
What did you get me?
Like I'm gonna tell you.
I've got Brittany on the line, too.
Hey, girl.
Oh, hey. Where are you?
I'm at Limits. What are you doing?
I'm at Pac-Man. I'm just shopping for Christy.
Cool.
And I'm shopping for Brittany's present.
Dude, guys, this is, like, so awesome. We've taken three-way calling to, like, a whole new level. We are
three-way shopping.
Can you hang on a second? Could I see that red sweater?
What did you say?
Nothing. Just talking to someone here at the store.
Oh, let me see the other one.
Who are you talking to?
I can't tell you that.
Do you think this one will be cute? That one looks too big. Do you have it in a smaller size?
Dude, I'm gonna love what I'm getting you this year.
Whitney, this is gonna be like the best Christmas gift ever.
And Brittany, you have no idea what I'm going to get you. I'm ready to check out. Hey girls, I'm ready to check out. Call me later, okay?
Yeah, I gotta go too.
Yeah, gotta finish shopping. See ya.
See ya.
See ya.
Bye. I'm ready to check out.
Well, I'd like
to get
my friend
the red sweater.
Thank you. sun. On Christmas Day, 2,000 years ago, the birth of a tiny baby in an obscure village in the Middle East was God's supreme triumph over good and evil. Untethered by time, God sees all of us. From the backwoods of Virginia to the business district in London, from the Vikings to the astronauts, from the cave dwellers to the kings, from the hut builders to the finger pointers to the rock stabbers, he sees us. Vagabonds to ragamuffins, all of us, he saw us before we were born. And he loves what he sees. Flooded by emotion, overcome by pride, the star maker turns to us one by one and says, "You are my child. I love you dearly. I'm aware that someday you'll turn from me and you'll walk away, but I want you to know I've already provided. And to prove it, he did something extraordinary. Stepping from the throne, he removed his robe of light and wrapped himself in skin. Pigmented human skin. The light of the universe entered a dark, wet womb. And he whom angels worship nestled himself in the placenta of a peasant. Mary didn't know whether to give him milk or to give him grace, but she gave him both, since he was, he or she could figure, both hungry and holy. Joseph didn't know whether to call him Junior or Father, but he called him Jesus, since that's what the angel had said. Since he didn't have the faintest idea of what to name a God that he could cradle in his arms. Can anything make me stop loving you, God asks? Watch me speak your language, sleep on your earth, and feel your curse. Behold the maker's sight and sound as he sneezes, coughs, and blows his nose. You wonder why I understand how you feel? Look into the dancing eyes of the kid of Nazareth. That's God walking to school. Ponder the toddler in Mary's stable. That's God showing his milk. You wonder how long my love will last. Find your answer. That's me you see up there, your God, your maker. Nail stabbed and bleeding. Covered in spit and sin soaked, that's your sin I'm feeling. That's your death, I'm dying. But that's your resurrection, I'm living. That is how much I love
Easy with the setup, pal. Last year I fell out of this stable. It wasn't a pretty sight. Hey, I'm talking to you.
Whatever.
All I'm asking for is you to be a little more careful. In case you forgot, we do have a baby here.
I'm always being yelled at for something.
Look, folks, it wasn't my idea to be here. I was minding my own business, taking care of my uncle's sheep. And now, every year, I do this manger scene. All I'm asking for is a chance to tell my story. Or better yet, to tell this little baby's story. But I can see it's going to be another one of those years. I hope you're enjoying the Holidazzle. And if you get a chance afterwards, stop by. I'd love to chat with you.
Oh no, I'm going to be late for the annual Christmas pageant. What will the church do without me, the director of the pageant? And there's so much yet to do. Why, those little angels and lambs, they can't manage without me. I am the most important person this time of year.
Excuse me. Hello?
Who's talking to me?
Miss Christmas pageant director? I'm down here. Could I have 30 seconds of your time?
No, I don't have 30 seconds.
Okay, I promise not to take more than 20 seconds of your time.
I don't even have 2 seconds. I'm going to be late for Christmas.
Hey, slow down. You see what I mean, folks? Everyone's just in a hurry.
Oh, I have so much to do and no time to do it. Oh, where did I put those sale coupons? I know I have them here somewhere. Mom's going to yell at me for spending too much money on those Christmas gifts. Oh, here they are. Thank God for credit cards. I'll never leave home without these little wonders.
Excuse me, shopping lady. I have something I'd really like to share with you. It'll only take a minute.
Who's saying that? Oh, no. It's happening. I'm going crazy.
I have some really good news for you.
The only good news I can hear right now is, attention shoppers, there's a blue light special on aisle 7 by the toy department. Oh.
There goes another one. If you folks have any ideas how I can get someone's attention just long enough to share some good news, I sure would appreciate it.
Oh my gosh, did you see that hot guy parking the Jeep in the parking lot?
You mean the one that looks like he stepped out of Hollywood?
Yeah. How come we never meet guys like that?
I don't know. Hey, what'd you get your mom for Christmas?
Nothing yet. How about you?
Well, I got my mom a new blow dryer.
Really? Is that what she wants for Christmas?
Well, not exactly, but I need one, so why not share? You know, the Christmas spirit.
Hi, girls.
Did you hear that guy call us?
No, but I need one, so why not share?
No, seriously, do you think it's the guy in the Jeep?
Oh my goodness, how I look. Oh, I knew I should have worn my Tommy sweater.
No, it's me, the shepherd from Bethlehem, not from Hollywood. I'm down here. I'm sorry, I don't have a Jeep, and I don't care what kind of sweater you're wearing. It really doesn't matter.
What? It doesn't matter?
Of course it matters. Whatever, let's get out of here.
Wow. To think that the only good news this year is a four-wheel drive and some crummy sweater.
Look, Bill, can't you get anything right? I told you that the Johnson account is a matter of life and death. We need to close on this before Christmas. That's just 2 more days, Bill. Count them. 2 more days. My fiancé has charged so much money on Christmas presents that we're going to end up in the poorhouse. I want performance, Bill. And we don't have time to listen to any excuses. I just want to hear some good news.
Hey, Miss Businesswoman, I have some really good news. Do you have a minute?
No, I don't have a minute, and what in the world am I listening to?
Just a simple shepherd from Bethlehem who spends a lot of time with a baby named Jesus.
Can't believe it. A talking manger scene. What will they think of next to get people to buy more Christmas gifts? That's all anybody thinks about is money, money, money.
It's not about money, really. I don't have any money. Just a few sheep. And the Christ of Bethlehem. Can I talk with you? I'm down here, the shepherd. I'm sorry, I don't have a Jeep, and I don't have a sweater, and I certainly don't have any money. But I do have some good news that I'd love to share with you.
What could possibly be good news today?
Whoa. You really had a bad day, huh?
That's an understatement. Like the worst day of my life.
Would you care to talk about it? I'm not going anywhere for a while.
I might as well. Do you see this ring? I had everything riding on this stupid, lousy ring. And I love him. And maybe you can't understand what that's like, but I love Josh. Thing is, I guess he doesn't love me anymore. And you know, he didn't even have the nerve to call me on the phone and tell me that we were through. Instead, he sends me this stupid note telling me that he wants his ring back. Well, you know what? It really, really hurts.
I'm really sorry about you and Josh. And you're right. I don't understand, and I certainly don't know how you're feeling. But I know someone who really cares and who really does understand how you're feeling. If you have a minute, I'd love to share with you.
Why not? I've got nothing more to lose.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yes, well, apparently all the eastbound and northbound flights are now snowbound. So here we are. Oh, well, I'm just trying to enjoy it anyway. Oh, but security was maddening. It was crazy. I had to take off my shoes, my belt, my jacket. I was thinking, what next? I had to empty my pockets. Oh, and I lost a Christmas present. Yes, can you believe they took Bubba's hunting knife from me? I don't understand why they wouldn't let me bring it on the plane. They can't really think that I would have unwrapped that beautiful Christmas wrapping paper and pulled it out and killed somebody. Oh, well. You know, it's really interesting. You have to fly sometime. And you get on the plane, you sit down, and I had a window seat, and I was so excited, you know, I wanted to talk to people, and everybody was just kind of doing their own thing. But then the flight attendant started giving instructions about, you know, if an emergency happened, and so I was kind of paying attention. I thought, I better take notes. So I was really listening, and I looked around, and everybody was just kind of reading and looking out the window, sleeping. I thought, they're going to be in trouble if an emergency happens. You know, there's not going to be time to pull out that little card in front of you. But I was feeling okay until the flight attendant said, your seat may be used as a flotation device. Now, that made me a little nervous until I thought, we're not flying over any water. Why did I worry about that? It's not going to be a problem. So, I thought that we'd be singing Christmas carols on the plane, but they're not really all that friendly in the airport. Oh, well, I just sat down and looked out the window and thought, I'm just going to enjoy the view. It's beautiful, like God's cotton candy in the clouds.
Oh, yeah. Stephanie!
Well, you might have to...
I'm so tired!
I'll let you know when my flight's going to go.
I'm tired, too.
I'm so tired of going from airport to airport just to stand in a long line and take my shoes off.
Yes, I know, but you know, we have to do that because of those terrorists. You know?
Do I look like a terrorist?
No, you don't look like a terrorist. It sure would have been a lot easier just to come to the airport naked. We could have gotten our mammograms done at the same time.
I can't believe you said that. A public place? If my mama was here, she'd wash your mouth out with Lifebuoy soap.
They don't make Lifebuoy soap anymore.
Yes, they do. Lifebuoy soap is cleanliness next to godliness.
Let's go have a seat.
Besides, that new age foo-foo aromatic floats your stress up to the sky and drop it down in the middle of a daisy field bathtub kind of soap is evil.
I guess I'll be taking her present back.
Excuse me, young miss. Are these seats taken?
Oh, no. Well, sit down. I'll move over.
Sure.
Why, thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you. Thank you. Very kind. Oh, well, look at all this I have to deal with.
Sit down and get your shoes on. Come on.
Oh, I'm so tired.
You okay?
Yeah, I'll be fine. Just gotta put my shoes on.
Oh, look at this. Ooh, there's some good recipes. I can't wait to get home and make some great stuff for Christmas.
I gotta put my gloves on, too. Take your gloves off, man. Take your gloves off.
Oh, wow, look at those cookies. Oh, that's cute. Oh, the kids are going to like those.
Are you plunged?
Pardon me?
Are you submerged in the cleansing waters of our Lord's saving grace?
Oh, if you mean, am I baptized? Yes, I have been.
Oh, hallelujah. I don't have to worry about this one. Thank you, Jesus. Oh. Oh, Lord, please forgive me. I am so tired and weary.
Well, you should be tired and weary. The last 3 hours you've been preaching and singing on 2 airplanes. They don't call them red eyes for nothing.
Well, if you did not notice,
the people were listening to every word I was saying about the Lord. He didn't even get up and run like some people I know.
We were on an airplane. There was no place for them to run.
Well, don't mind me. You two go on with your reading there. Mm-hmm. I'll just take a little cat nap. Don't mind me.
Mm-hmm. We won't mind you.
Is she okay?
Oh, she gets like this all the time.
Really?
Uh-huh.
Where are you headed?
Oh, we're trying to get home for Christmas, and I'm telling you, you know what? It just can't be soon enough.
Me too. I can't believe the snow.
Oh.
You know, Mom always said to change your underwear before you leave. In case you have an accident, you'll have clean underwear on. And I thought, you know, if I was in a plane accident, I just don't really think it would matter a whole lot.
I'm sure you're right.
But I did put clean underwear on.
Aunt Edie would be glad to hear that.
I'm sure she would.
Yeah. Wow. She wouldn't have to worry about that.
What time is it? Terrorist. Stephanie. He doesn't know.
He who?
He doesn't know.
Don't do this to me. I know that look.
Oh, Lord, I'm getting my strength back.
Oh, no.
Oh, he doesn't know. Osama bin Laden.
It's Osama bin Laden, and you better sit down or you're going to go to jail. You can't talk like that.
Osama bin Laden, I'm going to seek you out.
You know what, we better get out of here before security.
Into the deepest, darkest caves I will go. And I will seek you out, and I will find you.
Maybe we should go get a cup of coffee or
something. And when I find you, I'm going to grab you and drag you out of your deepest, darkest cave and into the sunlight.
My stuff here.
And there, I'm going to take your shoes off. And after I take your shoes off, I'm going to close my
eyes.
And I'm going to scrub you down with Lifebuoy soap. I'm going to scrub you and scrub you and speak the word of God.
She'll eventually run out of time.
Scrub and speak the word of God, for the word of God is the word of God, and the word of God is God breathed.
Oh, look.
Scrub and speak until you repent of your evil ways.
And then
I'll take you to the Jordan River. To the Jordan River where our Lord Jesus was baptized. And there I'm going to plunge you.
Excuse me, FBI. You're going to have to come with us. You're under arrest. You can't be speaking like that in an airport. Sorry, ma'am.
How are you doing? Merry Christmas.
I tried to tell you, Aunt Eden. I tried to tell you.
Oh, you're going to make me miss my plane. Oh, Stephanie, hold the plane for me.
Should you do something?
Trust me, they're not going to keep her back there very long at all.
One for the little bitty baby, wrapped in swaddling clothing. He was born in Bethlehem.
Children go where I send them. Oh, shall I send them? I'm gonna send them to my two. Little baby, born for the little children.
children go where I send thee.
Where I send thee.
How shall I send thee?
Send thee.
I'm gonna send you two by two, three for Paul and Silas too. Four for the four that stood by the door. Five for the Christmas shepherd. Six for the six that never got
there. Hey, hey, hey,
seven for the seven that never got to heaven. And four. Go where I send thee.
Where I send thee.
Go where I send thee.
All for the little bitty baby.
Seven for the seven that never got to heaven.
Eight for the eight that stood at the gate.
Nine for the nine that looked so fine.
Ten for the ten commandments.
11 for the 11 riders.
12 for the 12 apostles.
And he was born.
Leave the garland alone. You know your brother always puts the garland on the tree. You can do the lights and the trimmings and leave the garland and the star for Joe.
But Mom, Joe's not even home to put this stuff on the tree.
Yeah, anyway, why is it such a big deal? You know Joe won't be home for Christmas. Deal with it.
Catherine Marie, you know better than to talk to your mother that way. Besides, honey, we don't know for sure that Joe won't be home for Christmas. Last time we talked to him, he said that some of the troops may be coming home. Let's not give up on that just yet.
I'm sorry, Dad. And I'm really sorry, Mom. I guess I just miss Joe. And I'm a little sad that he's not here right now.
Yeah, I think we all do, honey. But I'll tell you what, now that you guys are finished working with the tree, why don't you go set up the trains?
I get to put the snow around the track. You did it last year.
Did not.
Did too.
Bring it back.
No.
Still haven't heard anything from Joe yet, huh?
No, and I'm so worried about him. He usually emails us by Friday night. It's already Saturday afternoon, and we haven't heard from him yet.
Don't worry, honey. You know how things get out there this time of year. I'm sure he got busy, or he could have gone out last night. You know he does take after me in the looks department. I'm sure there's really nothing to worry about. We'll hear from him soon.
I suppose you're right, but I'm just so afraid he's not going to make it home for Christmas this year. And I'm just so worried about him. We really did have a good time last year, though, didn't we?
Nice Christmas tree, G.I. Jane.
Oh, hey, Gussie.
You know what they say. When life gives you lemons, make lemonade.
Yeah, when life hands you scraps, make a quilt. When you're down in the trenches...
All right, enough already. I get the point.
But I'm just getting started. When life goes...
Yeah, and I'm finishing it.
So, did you guys ride home yet?
Nah, just wait until the computer's free. I'm sure my mom's a nervous wreck by now. You know how my mom worries. Whew. Yeah. Although she's probably occupied. I bet they're putting up the tree right now. Actually, she's probably refereeing the fight between Katie and CJ.
Oh, yeah, that little sister of yours. She's a feisty one. Sure is cute, though.
Oh, Jake, come on. That's my sister you're talking about. And she's 12, you cradle robber. Man, do we need to find you a woman.
Now, I wouldn't say that. Remember, he also, last year, he thought your mama was pretty hot, too. He likes to get all ladies.
Yeah.
Trouble is, none of them like him. Anywho, we did have the best time at your house last year for Christmas, didn't we?
Oh, yeah, remember how surprised your mom looked when you came home with four extra guys just up for basic training, ready to hold turkey themselves?
Oh, I remember. I thought she was gonna kill me. I think it all worked out okay, though. That was a blast. And remember how we went to McDonald's afterwards because we were still hungry?
Remember how Jake also wanted to take a little sister along with us?
Oh, come on, she looked older than 12. What can I say?
Remember how he also wanted to bring your mom along?
Come on, I told you. I appreciate the beauty of a woman. What can I say?
You can say you're a loser. Man, that was the best time. And I still think Mom doesn't know we snuck out. I'm going to miss her cooking this year.
Me too. Of course, I won't want to ruin my great physique with all the turkey, mashed potatoes, Christmas cookies.
All right, enough already. So, have you told him yet? Won't be coming home for Christmas this year?
Nah, I've been putting it off. Last I talked to them, I told them they were going to let some of the troops home for Christmas. I just didn't tell them it wasn't going to be us. I guess I just didn't want to...
Private Martin, you're up next.
Well, looks like you have a chance.
You know, you're right. We really did have a great time last year. You know, I will never forget the look on your face when Joe came in with Will and Mario and Gussie and Jake. Boy, you were really shocked.
I know. I thought one turkey wasn't going to be enough for Joe, let alone all the troops. But I think we had enough to eat.
We finally got the train up. Now we need to start battling up, Jake. Mom, Katie wouldn't let me do the snow. She got to do it last year. It's not fair.
Well, the train's up now, so just let it go.
Fine, but I get to do it next year. So what are you and Dad doing?
We were just talking about the great time we had last year. You remember when Joe came home with all his buddies from basic?
That was so much fun. Gus let me wear his boots around the house, and Will showed me how to do push-ups. All of Jake to just talk to Katie and Mom the whole time. I can't wait to see what they teach me the next time they come home.
And Jake asked me to go with them to McDonald's after dinner, and Dad said no.
Katie, we're never supposed to tell Mom they went to McDonald's after dinner. It was supposed to be our little secret, remember? Sorry, I forgot it.
Don't worry about it. Your mother knew it already anyhow. She found the french fry boxes in the trash the next morning.
That was so much fun. I really hope Joe gets to come home this year.
So do I.
I think we all do.
Well, Mom and Dad, here I am again. Same old, same old. Can't tell you where I am or what I'm doing, but know that everything is fine. I was just talking with Jake, Will, and Gussie about when we all came home for Christmas last year after basic training. Mom, boy, did you ever look surprised. I thought for sure you would kill me. We sure had a good time, though. Can't believe the food filled us all up so well. We had so much fun. Remember, CJ, how he made you drop and give us 10? Boy, was that a blast. And Katie, remember how Jake wanted to ask you out? I told him that you're my sister and that just was wrong. And Dad, it was just so much fun to share our basic training stories and hear yours. Man, I miss hearing all of you right now. I guess I'm writing to say that we'll all have to take a rain check on that turkey this year. I'll miss you all a lot, but don't worry about me, okay? Some of the guys and I decorated a tree. It's not as good as the one at home, but it's nice. I guess you guys probably put up the tree today. Katie and CJ, I hope you both put some snow around the train. Who am I kidding? I bet you did it all, Katie. You know, it really is CJ's turn. Mom and Dad, do me a favor. Put the garland around the tree for me and make it look real nice, just like I always do. Well, there's lots of other guys standing in line waiting their turn right home. So I guess I'll try to talk to you all next week. Have a Merry Christmas. Oh, and save the star for me to put on the tree, because I will be home for Christmas, if only in my dreams.
Where the I fell on my knees as their song rang. a couple of things with you that about this program. It may be a little different than what, you know, what you've seen sometimes, what I've seen in that maybe it just kind of reflects what real life is all about, you know? The fact is, at every Christmas season, as I'm sure among us here, some of us are in sad times, some of us are in difficult times in our lives, some of us are on top of the world right now, some of us are, everything seems to be going right. Most of us will take some time during this season and we'll look back over the years of our life and we'll look at the good times and bad times and we'll look at the ways that we've grown and gotten older and the ways that we've changed. And we'll just kind of look at the journey that we take through life. You know, I think on a practical basis, that's a lot of what Christmas is really all about. Isaiah wrote many, many years ago, in the midst of a great time of turmoil in his nation, when many things were going badly, many people had forsaken God, it looked like everything would really kind of end for that nation sometime in the near future. And yet in the midst of all that turmoil, all that difficulty, Isaiah wrote that at some point, a virgin would be with child. And she would bear a son, and they would call him Emmanuel, which means God with us. The fact is, every life that's been lived since then and before that time, and even in the life of Jesus himself, there were good times and there were bad times. There were struggles and there were high points in his life, as like in all of our lives. But the beauty and the wonder and the joy is that in the midst of that, God is with us. God is with us. And my friends, that is good news. It is good news. From our congregation to your family, we pray, we hope, that this season, maybe more than ever, you will experience in a fresh new way God in you. And for because of you, there will be peace. Would you pray? Lord God, we thank you so very much that we have this evening to share together. We thank you, Father, that we could laugh together and we could cry together, that we could sing together, that we could just share a little bit of our journey together tonight. I thank you so much for all of these people, Father, the way you've worked in all their lives to bring them to wherever they are tonight. And God, I pray so much that you would touch every person here and every family here. And that, Father, we might experience you being with us in a joyous and peaceful way this year. And God, I pray even more that you would take us from this place even tonight and give us a heart like yours, Lord, to share that peace, that joy, whatever it is that you give us this year, to share that with somebody else. And Father, truly, we will come together again and again and again, from now throughout eternity. And just like those angels, and those who followed that star long ago, Lord, we will sing glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace and goodwill towards men. And it's in Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Thank you very much for coming this evening. We're going to close with one last song, and I'm going to ask at some point here, just just a moment that all of you would stand and just join this song with us. And we hope that you have a very merry and blessed Christmas. Thank you.